Good morning, children. Now let's start our new lesson, Importance of Language. So children, first we start with our lesson reading, then after that we go with the summary and meanings. So children, please underline the hard words and new words while reading the lesson. As far back in time, as when life began on earth, there has been always one form of communication or other. Microorganisms, plants and animals all communicate. A world without communication would be a very confused one. Animals communicate using sounds and body language. When a dog wags its tail, it means it is happy or playful. But if its body becomes rigid or stiff, accompanied by a deep-throated growl, it means another thing. The dog has given a warning and for one's own sake, one must take heed of it. In the early days, human communication happened through grimaces, means different facial expressions, gestures, means use of hands and legs, and tones, which involved variations in audible sounds. Early man used pictures for communicating. Archaeologists have found many cave paintings with cattle, weapons and the subject matter. The cave paintings can be considered as man's first attempt to create and evolve a language. Egyptian hieroglyphics is an elevated form of early communication which involved using pictures. But this process was long and tedious. Necessity is indeed the mother of invention, as the different forms of communication which were used since the beginning of time fell short in effectiveness. Something better had to be put in their place. This led to the evolution of language. However, this evolution did not happen in one day. It took a long time for language to come to its present form. It is for this reason of having better skills and the ability to communicate by using a language that man has been elevated above other life forms. Language, one must accept, is the bridge of communication. When an idea in one person's mind is transferred to the mind of another, we can say communication has happened between them. If A says something and B understands something else, that is not effective communication. For effective communication to happen, there must be a common understanding. For instance, a four-legged piece of furniture that is used for sitting is named as a chair under universal agreement. If suddenly somebody wants to call it a goat, it would lead to much confusion and chaos. Such similar agreements hold good for everything that exists. Otherwise, we would be living in confusion and misunderstanding. People would be just talking, but nobody would be communicating. In the modern world, we use English as a common language of communication. The English language spread across the world as a result of British colonialism. This has brought most parts of the world under a common umbrella. It has eased many processes and has led to a better understanding of ideas and concepts of an international level. In India, there are 22 major languages written in 13 different scripts. In India, there are 22 major languages written in 13 different scripts with over 720 dialects. The official Indian languages are Hindi with approximately 420 million speakers and English, which is also widely spoken. Hindi and many Indian languages use the Devanagari alphabet, which was originally used to write Sanskrit. It is written from left to right and can be easily identified by a horizontal bar on top of each letter. Each letter resembles a single consonant or oval. Most places in North India use variants of Hindi. The main languages in South India are Malayalam, Tamil, Telugu and Kannada. They are all Dravidian languages and therefore have some similarities with each other. Much of their vocabulary has been borrowed from languages such as Hindi, often resulting in only minor differences in pronunciations and meanings. The history and culture of people are preserved in their language, whether oral or written. Each language has its own peculiar features. It tells a lot about the people speaking them, their culture, tradition and customs. Loss of a language means a great loss in terms of culture and tradition. Some of the legends and stories of some communities, groups, religions and races are passed on orally. They live in the minds of people. The relevance of keeping a language alive comes into play here. Somebody should take the trouble of putting them down in books. Otherwise, a rich heritage and a collective memory of a group of people would be lost forever. And that would be a shame. Some of the Indian languages don't have their own script. For example, Konkani does not have its own script but rather uses Roman, with same as English, with different axis symbols, or Devanagari scripts. The vocabulary also changes with the different regions it is used in. For instance, Konkani spoken in Kerala uses some Malayalam words, and Konkani that is used in Karnataka uses Kannada words. Many aboriginal, indigenous, native, tribal languages die out because of lack of alphabet or written form. When it happens that the youngest speakers of a particular language are the generation of grandparents, the pathetic future of that language could only be imagined. An indigenous language is a language that is at risk of falling out of use, generally because it has few surviving speakers. If it loses all of its native speakers, it becomes an extinct language. Unless an honest effort is made to preserve such languages, they cannot survive. Under the scheme Protection and Preservation of Endangered Language of India, the Mysore-based Central Institute of Indian Languages is working on the protection, preservation and documentation of endangered languages. Some critically endangered languages as per UNESCO are Amul, spoken in Manipur, Bhakti, spoken in Himachal Pradesh, Nihali, spoken in Maharashtra, Toto in West Bengal and Toda in Tamil Nadu, among many others. While we use language in our daily lives, it will be good if we also use it not just as a basic communication tool, but also as a medium of peace and better understanding. Man has been endowed with great wisdom. Language is an important tool of practical application of that great knowledge and awareness. All languages deserve respect irrespective of whether they are used locally or internationally. Just as we take pride in using language, so must we take good care in preserving what we have. It will be a blessing for many generations to come. So children, we completed our lesson reading. After this, you should write these underlined words in your classwork neatly for two times.